Hi guys, I've only gone and upped the ante. It's not a G3, but it's a G5. 446 gigabyte SAS drives, not sure of the specification. Single processor, fully loaded with RAM. That's a SAS card at the back there. As you can see, it's already pre-installed with Server 2008 R2. This is how old this machine is. No tricks here. Cables, VGA, monitor, server. This is going to be the real deal. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to pause this video. I really apologize about the noise. There's nothing I can do about it. I'm going to pause this video. I'm going to restart recording when I'm actually creating the RAID array and talk through what I'm actually doing for those of you who are interested. I won't go on too long. I know it can get a bit boring. What we really want to see is RAID in action. What we really want to see is sticking that 14 volt Bosch battery through one of those hard drives and making sure the operating system still works. I really, really hope I can find a way in. I'm not sure what's under here. Maybe a PCB. I'll see if I can remove this. Looks like it's riveted in place, or it might be just the caddy. I will double check before I stick the drill through. I don't just want to destroy the server and not be able to demonstrate what RAID does. So I'm going to pause the video now. We'll resume whilst creating the RAID array. Guys, I've come through for you. DL360 G5. We are going to destroy two of these drives and demonstrate RAID 6 in action. Now, as you can see, pre-drilled a hole here. I'm going to actually, that one lands in the wrong place. I'm going to drill another hole round about there. So we're going to end up sinking. Like you can see, this was a trial I did previously. That would absolutely destroy that drive through that hole. And that one is too low. It comes out about there. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to view, see, it says recovering all of the hard drives. Physical status is okay. And I am going to delete that RAID array. Press F8, press F3, saving configuration. I'm going to create a new drive, RAID 6. RAID 6 allows us to lose two drives out of an array. So were this a larger server, or were it to have five drives in instead of four, could lose two, right? I can still lose two anyway. Four drives is your absolute minimum. So I'm going to go ahead and create that now. You have selected blah, blah, blah. F8 to save the configuration. Configuration saved. We'll exit this. And then we'll boot from the USB stick, which I've conveniently already placed in the back. I'll just wait for that now. I mean, to be perfectly honest, this is, you know, just, it's a bit of fun, really. Absolutely do not do this at home. I can't be more serious about the fact that you should not be sticking drills through. Now, this server, let me take the cover off. The reason why I'm confident to do this is, firstly, I've worked in IT for years and years and years, and I've done far worse than sticking a drill through a hard drive. These power supplies here, these are mains voltage, that's 240 volts. Where they come into this system, can I see that? Can I take that there? Here, this is essentially the safe side. Look, touching those, not getting an electric shock, great, I'm not gonna die. If you mess with these, if you spill anything on them, you can absolutely, you could cause a fire, you could electrocute yourself, it could result in death. So do not recreate what I'm doing. This is for entertainment. value only. I do not recommend you doing it on any of your own equipment. I've said, if you guys would like me to produce a different video in the future whereby I do something else, I don't know, can we do something else with this today? Once we've drilled that whole hard drive out. I tell you what, let's start installing Windows. I want you to see that this is completely genuine. Look, there's the VGA cable. Now, I've seen Linus from Linus Tech Tips show you guys that he's not cheating previously, so I'm going to do the same. There are obviously some doubters out there. And I want to make sure that everybody knows I'm being completely genuine with what I'm doing. Just want to demonstrate extreme server hard drive failure for my own entertainment as much as yours. But I really, really appreciate the comments that you've left and the 3.3 million people that have watched the previous video. Computer explodes was a little bit of a stretch of the imagination, but you know, it was all meant in good fun, and I really, really enjoyed interacting in the comment section of that video. And I think the idea is to probably make a few more along the same lines. So what can we do to this today? Okay, so it wants to go now, does it? There we go. Yeah, so that's Windows installing. What can we do to this today? Well, we're going to drill these two drives out. That there, if I show you the depth, it's going to go straight through it. But that hole there basically just went between the caddy and the drive. So I'm going to re-drill there. I'm going to set the GoPro up. Trying to use a drill and a GoPro, or holding the phone like I'm doing now. So we'll stick the GoPro there. I'll check the camera view angles out first. This Bosch drill is absolutely useless. I'll use something a bit more meaty, one of those Aldi specials. And then what else can we do? What else can we do? Well, if I pour water on it, then essentially that could result in, well, let's face it, death. Highly unlikely. I know the trip switch will go, or fuses. Ah. Oh, hello. This little beauty. Also known as the processor toaster. Mark II. So we'll drill the hard drives out. Not long now, we'll drill the drives out, and then we'll apply some heat to the aluminium heat sink of the processor there. Really cool. It's a quad core Xeon. These memory modules are 1 gig, so there should be 8 gigs installed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For some reason, it's only detecting 5. Some of you were going to be, understandably, a little bit upset that I'm going to destroy this computer equipment. Well, I'll tell you now, this was manufactured somewhere in the region of around 2008. So it is absolutely not fit for purpose now. There is an issue with the memory modules not detecting properly. They've all been reseated. There's obviously some dodgy memory. It's a quad core Xeon. It's pretty useless at the end of the day. The hard drives need erasing anyway, so they'll all be receiving before they go to recycling, a good bash with a hammer, and that should make sure nothing's ever retrievable from this. Even though it's a close look in, as you can see, this is a dual socket system, but there's only a single processor installed. There's no fan on the heatsink. These banks of fans here force the air through. So this shroud, which I've taken out, get rid of that. This shroud directs the airflow through the power supplies from the front fans and this here. So we've got processor, CPU socket empty, and we've got a RAID controller with a 256 megabyte cache. There's also a failed battery on that RAID controller as well, so that's no good. And then we've got your memory modules. Can't remember what these are. DDR2. They'll be registered ECC. This will be some kind of chipset for the motherboard. And then we've got the HP ILO. And maybe what seems like some kind of memory module. I'm not entirely sure. I think Nanya, they make RAM there. But again, and there we've got the ATI onboard graphics. And that's an ES1000. And then a SAS card. And that SAS card can, it's going to go in the bin. It's 6 gigabit SAS. It's not fast enough for any kind of modern day applications, especially not in the job which I do now. We're looking at 32 gigabit fiber channel and a minimum of 12 gigabit multipath SAS. These drives are all 146 gigabytes, 10K SAS. I'm not sure whether they're dual port or not. They're not, they are slow. They're just not fast enough for modern day applications. Not for what we do anyway. And so that's a guided tour. As you can hear, it's quite noisy with the lid off. I'm going to stick the lid back on. I'm going to come back when this Windows installation has passed 100% completed and we've rebooted. I'm going to install hardware info. Switch back to me. I'm going to install hardware info and the HP array configuration utility, so you can see that all of the drives are present and healthy. We'll keep that open, and then we're going to slam this drill through those holes, and we're going to see those two drives fail. Hopefully the server won't crash. It might do, I can't promise that it won't. When the drill goes into the hard drive, the idea is to just essentially go through the hard drive casing. I'll switch back to this. Go through the hard drive casing. And then inside, come on, focus. No, is it not going to focus? Not to go all the way through and destroy this integrated circuit board, because if we destroy that, there's a good chance the controller here might crash or flip out. So I think if we go through the case, what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove this lid so you can see inside. If we go through the lid here, smash into the platter or whatever else. In fact, are we going to hit the platter there? We're not going to hit the platter, but well, I'll tell you what, I'm just going to pause for a minute. We'll remove this lid and we're going to see exactly where this drill bit is going to land, because if we're going to break this, we want to make sure we're breaking it properly. Okay, so I'll be back in a moment. Single blade failure. Fan solution not fully redundant. I'm not surprised. I can live with that. I did smash a screwdriver into it. This will be the interesting part. Gosh, it's noisy now. This will be the interesting part. Right. Burnt plastic. Is it going to load Windows? Is it going to pick those drives up? The working ones, at least. One logical drive. Back of the net. Bays 1 and 2 failed. I'm not surprised. Oh, come on. Good wholesome family fun. I can tell you now, my wife definitely wouldn't think that this was fun. Oh my God, look at that. We've went right through that hard drive. I don't think we're going to get that out because obviously the drill bit snapped off in there, but we can give it a go. Oh. Let me get those bits into the bin. You can see, well, you can't see daylight through it. We didn't go all the way through, but you can see that is that's ruined. But hey, we're into windows, so we're going to give it one last just chuck this in the bin. I'm going to have to sweep those filings up. Don't want the dog getting them in a paws. Right. One last thing. What can we do? Let's log in. I'm really sorry, it's getting pretty noisy now. Can't do anything about that. No other failures. Hey, I wonder if we unplanned shutdown. I'll load hardware info up again. We only want the sensors. I'll try not to heat it up as quickly this time. Maybe we could take one of the dims out. We've got our temperatures there. We'll give that another blast with the... with the old hot machine. Is it going to recover? Yeah, it went off the charts. So it obviously doesn't go any higher than 84 degrees. And once we get to 84 degrees, the thing will either shut down or just stop recording. There we go. That engineering, these fans, the way this server is put together is brilliant. It's just wow. Now, what's the next thing we can do? Should we pull out a memory module whilst it's running? Now, I know we've got a fault with the memory. Let's have a look at this. Task manager. How much memory is installed? 5 gigs. That's weird. Shouldn't be 5 gigs, it should be 8. We're gonna remove a dim. Let's see if this crashes this server. Server resiliency tested to the extreme. That has definitely crashed. We can't stop there. We're not giving up. This memory is supposed to be registered ECC. It's supposed to tolerate a memory failure. I guess putting it in when it's switched on isn't recommended best practice. Tell you what, let's have a bit of peace and quiet. I'm going to power this off. Ooh. Why is it doing that? I don't know. It still thinks it's hot. Right. Maybe it's because the lid's off. Now, I'm going to reseat these dims. Quiet down. There we go. As I said, do not do this at home. I actually know what I'm doing. I've been building servers and deploying Hyper-V and VMware and all kinds of crazy storage solutions for the past 18 years now. I mean, I cut my teeth on server NT, and I'm going to step away for a minute. Yeah, I cut my teeth on Windows NT. My first computer, Windows 3, I think it was, running DOS 5, and now we're on to Server 2019. VMware vSphere 7. We're doing some really interesting things with Dell VxRails at the moment. Hyperconverged storage and networking compute solutions. Absolutely loving Dell's kit. It's really good. Still 5 gigs installed. Advanced ECC support, blah blah blah. Well, I'll tell you what, let's test the enhanced ECC support. Let's spray something on it. Little bit of GT85. Really, really, really do not do this. It could obviously catch fire. I've got fire extinguishers over there and a fire blanket. It isn't going to catch fire. And if it does, I'll just carry it straight outside. But don't do this in your own house. Booting Windows and apparently that would make it go a bit better. Let's have a bit of lube on there. Nah. That has definitely killed it. Or has it? No, it hasn't killed it. Just move this out of the way. I can't believe. I can't believe she's still going. Look, guys, no tricks. HP. Hats off to you guys. Hats off to you. I mean, this server was never... I mean, had I put water in there, that might be a different kettle of fish, but this server was never designed to experience this kind of punishment. And I mean, it's 11 years old, and she's still working, despite having Has that done it? Have I broken it for once and for all? Oh, I've gotta absolutely love this thing. Well, I mean, she seems pretty indestructible, so what else could we possibly do? Kind of running out of ideas now, guys. The next thing is water. Or the Widowmaker. No, can't do it yet. I'm having too much fun. I love hammers. Does it report? No, it doesn't report memory. Doesn't report memory temperature. What else does it report? So no memory temperature. Oh, hang on a second. Yes, it does. Those are the memory temperatures there. Those are the memory temperatures. Right. Let's see what happens when we heat one of these up then. Whoa! You see that spike to 127 degrees? That's absolutely insane. I know it's not currently at 127 degrees Celsius, but it's still hot. Let's do the back one, shall we? That's just astounding. I wonder if that memory module is going to come back down again. Average maximum 127 degrees Celsius. Right. This is... Guys, I'm going to go for it now. I'm really going to heat this thing up. I will give the memory some heat. Let's see if we can cook one of the modules. See if it carries on running. Probably won't do, but I'll do it nonetheless. And then if it's still running after that, I'm going to smash it with a hammer. Right. So, channel zero. Ah, dim one, there we go. Oh well, I suppose we'll give it one more go. One more go. This video is much longer than I planned on it being, so I do apologise that you're going to have to jump around to see the bits and pieces. I've just enjoyed myself far too much. I really apologise for the shaky camera work. She's going to boot. So these had oil sprayed on them. These two have been blasted with a blowtorch. Uh-oh, we've only got 2 GB of RAM installed. System halted. No valid memory in bank A. Right, okay, we're gonna fix that. I am not surprised. We are going to remove that module. Jesus, that's hot. Ow, too hot to touch. Yeah, too hot to touch. Christ, there is some heat in there. I am not surprised for 1 minute that those aren't working. And we are going to move one of those modules, which hasn't been completely baked, and see if we can breathe some life back into a... Jesus, those memory modules must have reached like 100 and... I don't know, maybe a couple of 100 degrees Celsius. They've still got some serious heat in them now. Jesus, yeah, they're far too hot to touch. I'm not surprised by that. I've put that on there to see if I can direct a bit of airflow through the CPU into the memory. Come on. You know you want to. I love it. Absolutely love it. Invalid memory configuration, mismatched DIMM, blah, 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 blah. Right, let me just try. I'm going to pause the video. I'm going to try and fix this error. I'll be back in a few minutes. So I've chopped those server modules around. We'll see if she boots. Oh, it absolutely stinks. 2 gigs of memory, advanced ECC support. Is it going, Windows 12 isn't gonna, server 2012 can't boot, so look at that little memory. Two gigs. Those must be 512 meg sticks. That's going to boot. I'm going to try these other memory modules again. Whichever moron installed these however many years ago didn't put them in the correct banks anyway. So we've got two. Seems to be missing a module somewhere. Hey ho. This one surely won't work. Absolutely reek. Probably give myself like some horrific disease. Would you believe it? It's more hassle. Go. It's more hassle to stop recording and start again than it is to take you all on the journey to pick the crap up off the floor. those, surely to God, they can't work. They're just singed. I mean, that's not gonna stop this lovely old girl from booting. See what kind of error messages we're presented with. Getting a bit tired now, guys. Been messing around. 5 gigs of RAM installed. Would you believe it? I'm literally flabbergasted. Those memory modules were heated up. It might be that the charring is just on the edge and the soldering to the between the memory modules and the PCBs is intact. Right, what else can we do? Okay. Right, what else can we do? We won't need much power where we're going next. I'll just choose the right drill bit. Nah, that's a bit too big. Maybe this one. Yeah, hang on. Just gonna pause it for a second. Obviously wanted to stick the drill bit in there. Server's loaded. Blah, 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 blah. Let's get logged in again. I should have stuck a network cable in, really, and then we could have watched YouTube. We could have watched a real tech tips channel, like good old Linus. Love watching those videos. Absolutely love them. They're fantastic. Really good content. Love his work. Love the reviews. Jay's 2 cents as well. Jay's 2 cents. He's a funny guy. They should do more with Linus. I do watch Steve. Jesus, those power supplies are getting a bit hot. No, they're not. They're fine. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Now, if I hit that, we're going to get no display out. If I hit that, then ILO's going to stop working. What else can I do without? I guess we could try and see if PCIe hot plug works. I mean, this SAS card's doing nothing, but anyway. Nope. She did not like that. Okay. It's the final countdown. The world's most rubbish drill. I am not going anywhere near the power supplies. However, nothing else is off limits. Let's please be plastic. Oh, there we go. Oh no, actually, if I break that fan, it will say fan redundancy, blah, blah, blah. Better not do that. It'll just shut it down. Single blade, fan solution, not redundant. Let's do the ILO chip. Smells a bit. So apparently, ILO chips are really, do you know what? I'm an absolute moron. The ILO system monitors everything, the fan speeds, the voltages. So I am not surprised that killing Ilo has killed our fun. I think that's it. She's well and truly cooked. Oh. Wow. I'm literally controlling the server now with... Oh, there we go. So there's obviously... Do you see that tiny spark? Obviously shorting something out. Might have gone through one of the... Hey, baby! That was not supposed to be. Right, okay, you need to be quiet now. No, you really need to be quiet. Please be quiet. Silence at last. She lives. It's like it's possessed. That's it. Time to say goodbye. Time to say goodbye. Just pull those hard drives out. So if you're wondering, how can you securely erase the data on your discs? Well, this isn't a foolproof way, but it's gonna make it... Well, unsalvageable, pretty much. That will have smashed the platters together, destroyed the heads. Anybody trying to recover data off that would have a tough time of it. Well, I've really enjoyed our play today. I'm gonna take the power out. It does smell really bad. Burning PCBs, you don't really, just don't breathe that stuff in, it's horrific. Some of you might be wondering why I've done this. Well, the primary thing I wanted to do was to essentially show how redundant RAID 6 was, or RAID in general. And I think I've demonstrated that, but usually I generally get carried away with these things. And yeah, I'd say that we've definitely got a bit carried away. This server I'm going to finish up with will be recycled. It will be taken to a recycling center and basically disposed of in the proper way. So all of the electronics that go to the recycling center go off to be recycled or shredded gold recovery. I don't know, but it won't just go to landfill. I'm not completely stupid when it comes to these things. I do care about the environment. This server was, you know, going to be smashed to pieces anyway, so why not have some fun with it? But thank you very much for watching. I'm really sorry the video's gone on for far longer than I anticipated. Stick your comments down below, any suggestions that you have. I've got 6 or 7 more servers at home, so I think we should definitely smash some more stuff up. I've really enjoyed it. It was good. Cheers.